Tonight, the RFK Story, a special report from Fox News. Good evening, I'm Bill Redeker in Los Angeles. 2 decades ago, Robert Kennedy was shot here at the Ambassador Hotel. The assassin, Sirhan Sirhan, eventually admitted his crime and is now serving a life sentence in prison. But there are those who are still not convinced he was the only gunman. During the next half hour, we'll show you why the RFK story is still a murder mystery. We begin by returning to the Ambassador on that night, 20 years ago.
June 5th, 1968, just after midnight. It was an intoxicating night for thousands of Kennedy supporters who jammed the embassy ballroom at the Ambassador Hotel. As final voting results rolled in, it looked like their candidate had won the California primary.
I thank all of you who made this possible this evening. All of the effort that you made and all of the people whose names I haven't mentioned, but who made all, did all of the work at the precinct level, who got out the vote, who did all of the efforts and brought forth all of the efforts that's required. I was a campaign manager 8 years ago. I know what a difference that kind of an effort and that kind of commitment made. My thanks to all of you, and now it's on to Chicago, and let's win there.
Tired but exhilarated, the senator, his wife Ethel, and their entourage slowly left the crowded ballroom, surrounded by dozens of people, including Rosey Grier and Pierre Salinger.
He came off of the podium where he'd spoken.
We had to help Ethel down. She was pregnant, and we helped her down at the back of the stage. And
apparently somebody had planned him going out a door.
We changed the direction which we were going to go out.
And somebody said to him, well, we can go faster because there was a huge crowd in that room. Gigantic crowd. Let's sneak through the kitchen. And started through the kitchen. And there was Sirhan Sirhan standing by the door.
Senator Kennedy has been shot. Is that possible? Is that possible?
It could.
Is it possible, ladies and gentlemen? It is possible. He has. Not only Senator Kennedy, oh my God, Senator Kennedy has been shot.
In the ballroom, no one could see what was happening, but everyone knew. A hotel operator got word that something was wrong and called the police for help. It was frustrating.
Police department.
Yes, this is the Ambassador Hotel.
Yeah, I hear you.
They have an emergency. They want the police to the kitchen right away.
What kind of an emergency?
I don't know, honey. They hung up. I don't know what
we'll
happened.
We'll find out. We don't send out without...
I beg your pardon?
We have to know what we're sending on.
Well, honey, they want ambulance, too, so I don't know. I'll ring back. Hold on.
All right.
That's all he said and hung up. It's some kind of an emergency. I don't know what happened. You know, we have a Kennedy and everybody here tonight.
You have what?
Mr. Kennedy here.
Big
I
deal.
I don't know what happened, but it's something.
All right.
You want me to find out where
yes,
it is?
Yes, please.
Hold on. I think somebody was shot.
Oh, great.
Great. You want me to still try to...
Yes, ma'am.
Back inside the kitchen pantry, Mutual Broadcasting radio reporter Andrew West described the panic, the pandemonium.
Get the gun, Raper. Okay, now hold on to the guy. Hold on to him. Hold on to him, ladies and gentlemen. They have the gun away from the man. In this shot, they've got the gun. I can't see the man. I can't see who it is. But Senator Kennedy right now is...